There's some bright orange cloth caught on this sign. I wonder if Mike Lobb was trying to get away from this place in a hurry. Looks like someone doesn't want me to see what's going on inside. Well, they probably shouldn't have made this a puzzle then.
want a good look around, you might try knocking on the door.
Sheriff Buck! Oh, you startled me.
Snooping doesn't suit you, Agent Tatters. What are you doing here?
What the heck is going on in there?
They meet regularly and celebrate their cultural traditions. But that's their business, not yours.
There's something about this crew that seems off to me.
Agent Tatters, you're here to get the factory back open. Not to question or belittle the beliefs of the townsfolk.
I'm pretty sure I saw Glory Davner in there.
The waitress? I doubt it.
She was standing right there a second ago.
Time to go, Agent Tatters. I'll escort you back to the hotel. Make it an early night and turn in, Agent Tatters. I don't want to see you out here again tonight. And trust me, you don't want to be out here either.
Sheriff Bogg definitely isn't working with me. I'm sure I saw Glory Davner at the lodge. And now Glory Davner's sneaking around town. I'm going to follow her. Glory was headed toward the factory. I gotta catch up with her. Where am I? Wait, do I know you? You. You're the foreman, Isaac Davner. What happened to you? What are those things? The gnomes. Was that real? Yes? What is it? What happened?
I found you unconscious in the woods. Did they speak to you?
Did who speak to me? I'm looking at a photograph of the Brotherhood. Isaac and Mike Lobb seem to be part of this group, and they seem to be friends. Interesting. Okay, I'm gonna need some real answers now. What exactly is going on here? What's wrong with these people?
They are in deep meditation. If you open your mind and let yourself hear the whispers, there will be no mysteries in life you cannot solve. Speak to them yourself if you want solutions.
What are these little creatures I keep seeing?
They are not creatures. They are people, older than any of us, living in what nature still exists around us.
Isaac Davner's still alive, isn't he? The lock on the factory door. He didn't build it himself. You put it there to keep him in, or to keep people out. Why?
He has been spoken to. It is actually a great honor to have been chosen.
Chosen for what?
That is not for us to ask.
I'm gonna need a second to question these people.
Do what you must.
You see them, don't you? Listen to their words, their riddles.
Thank you.
That's a piece of the machine locking the factory. Where did you get that?
All we can do is open our minds. The language of the hidden ones is expressed in puzzles.
That's it. Only one more piece.
Rocks, trees, animals. Do you ever just stop and watch the birds, Mr. Tethers? A quorum of crows congregating in rows on a vine meant for clothes is an omen of woes.
That's all of the pieces. Now I just need to reassemble them. damn it! Where are you, you little thief? Gotcha. One of those things stole the last piece I need to get into the factory. Looks like it's headed toward the lake. Bjorn's people may try to protect it, I'm not sure. Either way, I'm getting that piece back. There's some bright orange cloth caught on this sign. I wonder if Mike Lobb was trying to get away from this place in a hurry. Let you people keep him locked up in a factory like bait.
I'm sorry.
I gotta get out of here. That was a close call.
What the heck happened here, Agent Tethers?
Sheriff Bob, Glory Dabner tried to kill me.
Come on, Tethers. You sure that sweet little girl?
Sheriff, I swear, she is not as innocent as she looks.
Okay, I'll go find her and ask her a few questions. You stay out of trouble now.
Oh. I like my office. It's warm in my office. It's quiet in my office. There are no maniacal gnomes or chainsaw-wielding waitresses in my office. I need to get back to the lodge, fix that gear, and get the hell out of here.